Right. We're playing outside of the baseball field was in front of an elementary school. And I thought it was Buckingham Palace for a second.
I don't know that you could use Greenwich as an example of the average school.
I know, but still.
Listen to that. Listen to that.
No, listen to this. I had to drive to Greenwich.
I had my hood to get to Greenwich.
I had my driver take me to Greenwich so I could watch my son's team. He's not on it. He owns it. Anyway.
Oh, the field was even nicer than the heliport. I couldn't believe it.
We drove from the hood where we live.
The hood.
To Greenwich.
The hood. Oh, my God.
The public housing project. In the Bronx,
right,
up to Greenwich.
Right.
It's about half an hour, 45 minutes.
Okay, now listen. You can't.
They bussed my family in.
They had French's mustard.
Leave it to you two to turn it into something tawdry, ugly.
No, just true.
Just ugly.
Just true. You wouldn't believe this school in the richest city in the world.
It's not the richest city in the world.
No, it's like third or fourth.
I think it's like second or third.
You wouldn't believe it. And they're crying poverty?
The rest of the country doesn't know how rich Greenwich is. You two yahoos would shut up.
Knows.
It's a fine, fine example of how nice our schools are.
You wouldn't believe I'm in Beverly Hills.
And don't know Greenwich is like Beverly Hills.
And there's these
you don't
these
know that
houses are gigantic. They're up on a mountain with a pool on a perch, and they're crying poverty. You are one with the people. You really are.
Don't even start with me. Don't even go down that road. Oh, the tales. I could tell.
You go ahead.
But Pat, you've told the story, what is it, in Texas, where you used to live, back when you lived in the slums.
When it was slums.
And you, there was that school near you that had, what, two arboretums in it?
It was at one time, I don't know if it still is, the largest high school. It was 1 mile long, end to end. And it had two arboretums. And we were like, I remember talking to you guys about this.
I didn't even have one.
I don't even know what an arboretum was. I had to look it up. What's an arboretum? It's got two of them.
Wait a minute. That's where you grow trees or something?
No, it's like, I think they're indoor swimming pools, I think.
And you wouldn't believe the toughness of the filet at the snack bar.
Okay, look.
You can't get decent duck a la ronge in the cafeteria.
Look, here's the thing. There are schools. Have you seen the schools here in Manhattan? Some of them, you know, you go like a block off of Central Park and they are huge.
I thought you were going to tell the truth there for a second.
No, you go, seriously, you go six blocks off of Central Park.
Uh-huh.
And there are schools that are, and this, remember, this is like the Badlands of Greenwich. You go six blocks. I don't want to send my kids to those schools.
Oh, no.
They're like jails.
Yeah.
They're really, really nasty.
They're so bad, they don't even name them. They're just numbered like you're in prison.
It's PS12. And you'll like it, PS12.
I'm public school 12. That's all I get. You can't call me Anderson Elementary.
Yeah, I know. It's nasty.
It is.
And these aren't the bad schools. You go to, there are bad schools.
Sure.
But come on.
But you don't fix them by building gigantic Olympic-sized pools. That's not the way you get better education.
And you don't need in these nice areas. I honestly live in a nice town. There are nice schools. You don't need that. It's obscene. Let's concentrate. You want to save teachers' salaries? Let's build normal buildings. Just normal buildings. There aren't office buildings that are this nice. I would never be able to. My business is a successful business. I don't build my business buildings that nice. And we make money. We don't spend money. We make it. All they do is spend money. We're worried about paying our teachers. Let's stop building these palaces.
Yeah, I mean, a legitimate expense for a public school is a higher teacher salary, so yes, you retain the best people.
Yes. Now, I don't want any kid going to a school that is breaking down. And what was the story that Bamo said? He was like, and a train runs through at 3:05, 5:05, and 9:05.
You can feel it rattle.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if that school exists. Mm. And it's on the train tracks. I'd like to see pictures of it. But we can build nicer schools, but we don't. You want a redistribution of wealth? Let's take the bad schools and make them decent, and take the new schools that we're building and not make them palaces. Our children don't need that. I grew up going to a private school. It was a Catholic school, but it wasn't like, you know, it wasn't like what Pat's kids obviously experience every day.
Yeah, at my house.
I mean, the linoleum was coming up off the floor. We had to use both sides of the paper. You know, we never wasted anything. It was not a palace.
Did you have to walk to school uphill both directions over broken glass? And by the time you got to school, your feet were cut to shreds and you liked it. And when you got there, the teacher would make you soak your torn up feet in rubbing alcohol. Is that what happened, Gramps?
If you think it's funny to make fun of my family, that we're all born without feet, so we had to drag ourselves to school uphill on broken glass both directions.
Both directions? Okay.
That's fine.
Was it over 10 miles?